This tiny Protolinus trilobite, barely more than a centimeter long, was slowly making its way through the landscape. Unfortunately for this quiet Middle Cambrian reef community, a volcano has erupted not far from the shore. Pyroclastic clouds, similar to what buried the people of Pompeii, was sent hurtling towards the reef. As it entered the water, turbid clouds swiftly choked and buried the trilobite, entombing it in fine volcanic ash. 510 million years later, thanks to modern technology like micro-CT scanning, we've been able to reveal the contents of this tomb, layer by layer, shedding more light into what we know about trilobite anatomy. Soft parts that we've already known, like their branching legs, which consist of the nether base, the walking endopod, and the gill exopod, is preserved here in detail, down to the spines and setae from every segment. For a long time, it was thought that trilobites have three pairs of post-antennal appendages on their head. Two normal branching legs, and here in Protolinus, another pair with a diminished gill that tapers like an antenna, and a barely visible vestigial walking leg. However, the CT scan has picked up what seems to be another extra pair, nestled right underneath the antenna, with no walking legs and an even more diminished, flagelliform antenna-like gill. The spiny nether base on this extra pair would have helped to tear up food items before entering the mouth. The trilobite's mouth parts consist of the hypostome, a structure that's suggested to be homologous to the labrum in modern-day arthropods. However, this fossil has revealed that underneath the hypostome is a previously unseen soft tissue that's been identified as the labrum. The CT scan even picked up how it connects to its esophagus and digestive tract. Another specimen, Gigutella mauritanica, was found with tiny brachiopods, bivalve mollusks, still attached to it with their shells open in a live position due to the very rapid burial. These specimens have shown that fossils involving pyroclastic burials have great potential in the future to yield more discoveries, letting these long-dead unfortunate creatures reveal themselves to us.